here with you guys today. So let's go ahead and get started. So welcome to our fifth wellness session for musicians. My name is Francesca Leo, and I'm the chair of the Puerto Rico Flute Symposium Wellness Committee and the founder of playingwithoutpain.com. I'm joined today by Dr. Jessica Koebbe, a member of the Wellness Committee and the chair of the Puerto Rico Flute Symposium Collaborative Piano Institute. She has her DMA in piano performance and specializes in helping teachers learn how to address performance anxiety and adopt mindfulness practices into their private teaching. She currently teaches at Mid-America Nazarene University and is the founder of Mindful Music Pedagogy. So our previous sessions have addressed the relationship between breathing to a number of different topics. All sessions are archived on the Puerto Rico Flute Symposium's Facebook page, as well as playingwithoutpain.com and mindfulmusicpedagogy.com. If you are a music educator and wish to share this video with your students, we also offer the recorded Zoom session, which you can find on YouTube under Playing Without Pain's channel. You may also send us an email at wellness@prflutesymposium.org, where we can share the MP4 files with you directly. We welcome viewer interactions as we broadcast today, and we also welcome any questions you may have. So please feel free to comment, and we look forward to talking with you. Today we will begin the body section of our wellness sessions and look further at performance anxiety, discuss how the body is affected by symptoms of performance anxiety, and how progressive relaxation can help alleviate symptoms to enable a more confident performance. So at this point, I will turn it over to Jessica.
Yeah, so like Francesca said, our past sessions have dealt with breathing, which is very important and rather foundational for the rest of the work that we're going to be doing. But a common complaint of musicians is that their bodies don't respond in performance in the same ways that they do in practice. And often that's due to increased physical tension. Sometimes it's also a combination of inadequate concentration. So determining whether errors in the performance are a result of physical tension or mental distraction can be difficult, but those are all things that we're pulling apart as we go through these sessions. So today, we're in our next upcoming few sessions, we're going to be dealing with the physical side of it. So we definitely believe that musicians benefit from having an awareness of our physical and mental states when we're practicing. And by developing that awareness, we can train our minds and bodies to work together to remain consistently calm in performance. And that freedom from physical tension allows us as performers to focus and then enables us to realize our full potential by operating at a level of increased awareness while trusting all the techniques and our bodies as we perform. So developing the ability to observe the signs of physical tension is the first start, the first place to start, and that will help us understand what we're feeling. And then as we become more aware of our bodies and where the tension is residing, we can hone our ability to regulate that muscular tension, which will then, like I said, it develops more awareness of the muscle groups in our body, but also we will be able to sense when that tension is present or when it's about to be present, and then we'll be able to release that tension quickly. The method I'm going to be talking about today was developed by Dr. Edmund Jacobson, and it's called progressive relaxation. He developed this back in the 1930s, and it's the intentional creation and release of muscular tension moving progressively from one muscle group to another throughout the body. The goal of the skill is to train the mind to recognize when and where tension is present in the body and then very quickly release it. So as this skill is perfected, greater muscular awareness is achieved, but it also allows for tension release of specific muscle groups almost immediately. So musicians who develop this awareness and practice this conscious tension release will be able to recognize and decrease physical tension that interferes in a performance. And then, of course, that allows us to perform at our most relaxed state, which is at our best level of physical tension to some degree. We want some tension when we're performing, but without that getting in the way. So once we've mastered this technique as musicians, we in practice, we become able then to to adapt it to performance situations, like I said. So then it becomes really second nature in a performance setting. But in order to do that, we've got to actually practice that. So we're going to talk today about a couple of strategies to do that away from your instrument, but also at your instrument. So Francesca is going to lead us through the first one here.
Great. Thank you, Jessica. So today I'll be talking a little bit about some findings and some techniques from Don Green's performance success book. If you don't have this book, I highly recommend you get it. It's a really great method for managing performance anxiety and also building your optimal performance. So breathing is one of the most important tools we have to counteract symptoms of performance anxiety in both our mind and body the moments before we step on stage. One of the most significant symptoms of performance anxiety that can negatively affect your performance is an increase in muscle tension. So here's a quote from Don Green's performance success book. Tight muscles result in poor performance, and good performances are almost always the result of relatively relaxed muscles. So that's some good quotes to reflect on as we discuss today. So as we discussed a few weeks ago, your breath has the potential to relax your muscles. Think of your body, how your body feels while practicing at home. Do you generally feel relaxed, free, at ease? Now take a moment to think of how your body feels during or right before a performance or audition. Does your body feel tense? According to Don Green, we tend to tighten up the muscles that we need to keep more relaxed when we feel anxious or stressed in performance. So singers and wind players tend to hold this tension in their throats and their shoulders, which inhibit their ability to breathe properly. String players tend to hold most of their tension in their wrist and hands. No matter where the tension lies in your body, it will almost always prevent you from feeling a full body connection and maintaining proper balance while you play, which is an essential part of performing. A good exercise from the performance success book is to identify the places you hold tension when you're under extreme pressure. So for me, I definitely hold tension in my throat, my left shoulder, and my left hand, which are all connected. So these areas are your key muscles, or the ones you must work on keeping relaxed in order to perform well and feel free. Identifying these muscles will allow you to invite ease to these areas while you are centering yourself before performances and auditions. It really helps me to lie in constructive rest while focusing on my key muscle areas and inviting ease, freedom, and space to these areas through my breath. So let's try this briefly together. Go ahead and either get in a comfortable seated position or lie down on the ground and gently close your eyes. We will begin by taking a few calming breaths to center ourselves and come to the present moment. When you're ready, take a few deep breaths and begin noticing the top of your head. Release any tension in your forehead and eyebrows. Release any tension in your jaw. Release any tension in your neck. Breathe through any tension in your shoulders, your arms, your chest, your abdomen, your legs, and your feet. Your whole body should feel free and weightless. Take a few breaths in here and notice all sensations in your body. Do not place judgment on them. Now, think about a performance experience you remember feeling really nervous for. Visualize it as closely as possible. What did the stage look like? What outfit were you wearing? Do you remember any specific smells? Do you remember seeing any specific faces in the audience or on a panel? How did the temperature of the room feel? How did you feel when you were playing? Did you feel like you were gripping at your instrument? Did you feel out of control? Now, briefly take another scan of your body as you continue to breathe. Are there now areas that feel tense or tight as you recall this experience? Take note of which areas these are, but do not place judgment or try and change it at this time. Take note of whether any emotions came up while you were doing this visualization, and make a note in your mind to come back to these emotions in the future to ask them what they're trying to tell you. Come back to your breath, and we will take another brief scan of our body, inviting a release of tension in any areas that may need it. Let your breath be free and spontaneous. Let your body melt into the ground beneath you and feel fully supported by the ground. Slowly blink open your eyes. So the muscles that felt tense or tight as you recalled a stressful performance experience can be identified as your key muscle areas, otherwise known as the muscles you need to work on keeping relaxed in order to reach your optimal performance. These key areas could include your neck, your jaw, your throat, your face, your left or right shoulder, your left or right arm, your left or right hand, your back, or your legs. As Don Greene states in his performance success book, you can counteract this by doing a body scan, as we just practiced, and a centering exercise. So as you continue to breathe fully, begin to scan your body for tension, especially in your key muscle areas right now. On each inhale, check one area, which could be maybe your face, your eyebrows, your jaw, your forehead. Then breathe out any tension you find on the exhale. Continue to do this for 3 to 7 breaths until all your key muscles are relatively relaxed and ready to function well. So you can do this in 3 to 7 breaths right before you perform. You could practice it while you're at home and before you turn on a recording device to make a recording, because sometimes I feel nervous before I put on my recording device to do a run through. So you don't need to worry about making yourself relive your stressful performance experience for the centering exercise. That was just an exercise to identify your key muscle groups. So before a performance, you want to make sure that you are relaxing your key muscle areas. So Jessica, I'm going to ask you a question, put you on the spot. Did you notice any key muscle areas that were feeling tense when you were revisiting a stressful performance experience? And do you want to talk about that for a minute?
For sure. For me, it's, well, it, as you say, it all connects. So for me, it's just everything that just, you know, tightens up. And then of course I noticed it a lot in my forearms, which then affects the agility of my fingers. But I also just noticed all my breath getting shallower and shallower, which of course, as we talked about before, is a sign of overall body tension. So yeah, for sure. A specific performance came to mind. And then also I was just chuckling because as everyone can tell, we had technical delays starting this. And so I was just thinking about how we can use these types of techniques in our everyday life, away from the piano, or in my case, or flute in your case, and have these opportunities to practice relaxing because we think better and we make better decisions when we're calmer.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, so I'll turn it to you for the last portion of this class.
Sure. So the body scan that Francesca did is so vital because, like she was saying, we have tendencies and areas that we gather tension, whether or not we're aware of it. So that's a great exercise to do to, if you're not sure where your spots are, to do, and then gradually you'll become more aware of like, yep, there's my right shoulder. And for me, it's definitely my right shoulder because I'm not holding an instrument, but sitting at the keyboard, right shoulder definitely gets more tense. Although both of them often come up to my ears. So the progressive relaxation technique that Edmund Jacobson developed was, a bit like the scan, although it involves the intentional creation of tension and then the intentional release of it. And I found, at least initially, that was a really important step for me because I walked around in such a state of tension for so long and I didn't even know it. So when someone would come up to me and say, oh, you just need to relax, I thought I was relaxed. I didn't know what relaxation felt like until I was in the moment of actually like trying to make myself more tense and then realizing like I can't because I'm already such a ball of tension in my shoulders or jaw or wherever that I couldn't relax it. So if that's you, then this particular exercise might be good. What it does is it just trains the brain to communicate with very specific muscle groups in the body. And over time that becomes a quicker, highway of communication so that you can just, you know, notice that right shoulder and you've developed this little system with yourself to turn off the tension and you know what that feels like. So part of this involves actually, like I said, creating the tension and releasing it, but also labeling what the tension feels like to you and then what the release of that tension feels like. So you may, it may be different for every muscle group, but perhaps when you're, you know, you're tensing up something in your face or your shoulders, that might give it a word, give it an image. It doesn't have to make sense to anybody but you, but give it some sort of name and label as to what that feels like. And that becomes the imprint, the word you're going to use with your brain and your body to help cement that connection between the two. And then likewise, when you release the tension, give that a name. The one that I use and that I've used with my students and it seems to connect well, because I think we all know this feeling, is when I relax and when I want my shoulders to really drop, I use the image of this really heavy weighted blanket that's just wrapped around. And all of a sudden, we all know that feeling of like when somebody just puts their arms around your shoulders or when you wear a heavy weighted blanket, that total envelopment and that relaxation that comes from that. So whatever that image or word is, I'd encourage you to think of that as we walk through this. So like Francesca's exercise, you can be laying on the floor, you can be sitting comfortably, you can even stand with this, but ground yourself in such a way that you feel stable. And today we'll work in the large muscle groups, and then I think you'll be able to see easily how this translates to working in smaller and smaller muscle groups, which are, it's probably a more relevant technique for musicians, but we'll start here with the big muscle groups. So first of all, we're going to start at the top of the head and work down, which is the whole progressive part of the idea of progressive relaxation. And what we're going to do is just try to constrict the muscles in our head and our face and hold that for 5 slow counts. And as you're doing that, you're going to label what that feels like. And then you're going to relax everything back down and then label that. And when you're doing this on your own, you can repeat that as often as necessary. But I definitely encourage you to actually use your hands to touch that area that you're focusing on, because it will give you a better sense of whether or not you're actually relaxing, or just draw. It gives a tactile way to draw the brain and the body to that specific muscle group without engaging the others. And that's the key, is that you really want to isolate these groups as we go. So let's do that. Let's start at the top. So scalp, ears, forehead, face, and lower jaw is fine. Well, let's just really constrict that and hold it, label it, and then let it go. And maybe just touch each of those areas, make sure they're actually relaxing, and label that feeling. Now moving down to the neck and the upper shoulder. Really tense that up, but try not to engage any other muscle groups as you do that. Label this feeling, hold it, and then release it. And again, it might be helpful just to place your fingers on those areas. Let's try that spot again. So, isolating the neck and the shoulders, tense those up. And relax them. I'm going to work down through the arms. So tense your biceps and triceps, hold it, label it. Release it. Maybe even shake your arms out, let them hang down heavily towards the ground, and label that. Same thing with your hands. Squeeze them together. Really tense them up. Label that feeling. And then release them. Label that. Now we're going to focus on the back. So if you can, isolate upper back. Really draw that in. Tense that up. And release it. And if you have those areas where you know you've locked in that tension so well that it's hard to release it, you might do it a few times in those areas. Now working down through the lower back, maybe place your hands there on the back, a small of your back, tense that up. If you want, you can wrap around and include the abs in that. And relax. And label that feeling. The labeling is very important because it's the connector between your brain and your body to help you recall what the feelings are, so that when you're in a performance setting and you're like, really tight in my shoulder, and then you can recall like, oh, I feel really, for me, the word I use is scrunchy. I just feel really scrunchy right there. So I'm going to imagine that weighted blanket feeling, and then boom, the muscles just have that sense memory and can relax right away. So now let's go through the thighs, tensing up the thighs, giving that a name, and releasing that, and giving that a name. Working down through the calves, tensing that, releasing your calves and naming that. And then in the feet, let's curl up the toes and scrunch at those as much as possible. And then release. And of course, throughout all of this, you're doing your breathing. And most naturally, that deep breath occurs when you're releasing the tension. So don't forget to tune into that part of it. So that is a very brief look at the progressive relaxation exercise. And like I said, you can actually use that then to isolate much smaller muscle groups. If your hands are the issue, you can just go through and isolate each individual finger or joint. Same thing in your arms. If you want to, you can just go through and touch each different section and practice tensing and releasing. So thank you for joining us today. Thanks for your patience with our Zoom to Facebook issues. If you'd like to look up our previous sessions, which were on breathing, you can find them on the Puerto Rico Flute Symposium page. You can also find them archived on Francesca's site, playingwithoutpain.com, or on my site, mindfulmusicpedagogy.com. And if you have a comment or question, you can drop it down in the comment section here and we'll address it in the future sessions. I'm really excited because next week's session, we will have a guest presenter, Jay Tapia, who's a licensed massage therapist and is also a member of the Puerto Rico Flute Symposium Wellness Committee. And they'll be speaking about the positive impact that breathing and self-massage can have on the lymphatic system and our immunity. So we hope that you have a restful week and we will see you next time.